Right? Good morning, everyone. Good morning, Nigerians. Good morning, those people who see the outside Nigeria when they listen to us, when they hear us, when they view us, when they do everything what they do for here. This is not Solab Television. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year in advance. How the Christmas? Ooh. We don't do the Christmas there. We don't do December 25th. Today is 27th. Today we still celebrate today. Shall I go tell you now why we celebrate today? You understand? I throw a salute to everybody. Right, my Nigerian friends and London friends, London fans and friends. How na day? We don't join again. We don't meet again. We thank God. We thank God. My name never still change. As my fans, then they call me Omolaje Tunso Ibo. That name don't he don't Omolaje Tunso Ibo. But today when I go hear small about it. But I know they here alone. Are they here with one of my brother, my Ogbonge brother? Now Ogbonge brother, Olawale, how you doing?
I did fine, Omolaje, so you go.
How you did? How the Christmas?
Oh, fine.
I've written. How you take a duam?
I just went to my uncle place, sha.
Uncle place.
And there I did, right?
Don't tell me, say the Christmas, no day by day.
The Christmas day, okay.
They good, eh?
Okay.
For we say we for Solab here, the Christmas day, okay. Make we say twali, three twali to the chairman of Solab Television. Twali. I'm going to say three bosa again for the chairman again.
Bosa.
Of course, the chairman know where they talk to bosa. The chairman will chop. We still allow that people to chop.
Yes.
Some people go chop, then go clean mouth. They're not going to allow make those people, they work with them, make the chop. But on Friday, Omolaje Tunso Ibo. See, tears plenty. Chairman, you try.
Thank you.
Chairman, we thank you very much. Oh, everybody waiting for here. This is mega the true salute to you. Chairman of Solab TV. Chairman, they for away and they hear us. And everything we chairman give us, none of them they deliver for here. Chairman, you see our hair? Thank you, sir. We they say God will bless you. As you remember us, we know say we there for your mind. As you remember, big man, we remember.
Small
big man, we remember small man. German, your pocket. The mouth of your pocket go the dirty. Now pray you. If mouth of somebody pocket the dirty, which means say money they inside.
Yes.
Somebody they shook money for there.
Yes,
if they
yes.
shook hand,
yes.
they bring out money. So the mouth of the pocket go the dirty.
Yes,
German, your money not go finish.
Amen.
For where you bring that money, take give us Christmas food.
Amen.
Wale, we thank God.
Thank you.
Make we quickly enter inside the newspaper headlines for today. Then go say, wait, Lasisi, my dear Lasisi, Sarah Lasisi, Sarah, they come. You know, say, yeah, Sarah, they come. Sarah, go do some report first, and in the combat. Make quickly enter inside paper report for today. For inside newspaper for today, paper headlines for today, oh, they say, Archbishop Desmond Tutu don't die for the age of 90. That South African activist, Archbishop Desmond Tutu don't die at the age of 90. Wale, you know one thing. One time they say this man died. Then the news got spread. Later we come here say no die. So this one now when they talk say the man, they say our presido Oga Muhammad Buhari, Chief Olusegun Obasanjo and Dapo Abiodun and other people, they mourn Archbishop Desmond Tutu. Then they mourn. You see, make you know how important the man they. No, when somebody they important. I even hear from Baba Chief Olusegun Obasanjo. He said the man not like family like brother. See, he didn't lose somebody like brother. You understand? That the thing when the palette talk with that one. So we Africans to everybody with the mourn the man try. We know as the man takes that.
Yes, yes,
90
yes.
years old. There were 90 years. May you so
okay.
May you so rest in peace. Another story for inside paper for today. They say NDLEA chairman Oga Buba Marwa. They say he don't seize drugs for 2 months. What about 60 billion naira?
Yeah.
60 billion naira drugs.
Hard drugs. Drugs.
For 2 months.
No, no, no.
Wait till you can see for 4 months. All right, welcome back to the program Solab AM Niger Live. Now with this, so my name still remains Omo Lajetun Soibo. Sorry, with this, sorry for the technical fault. We thank God for our technical crew here. When do the possible, when do everything possible best. So we come back again. We thank God. Olawale.
Yeah.
How far?
I do.
So we continue with our program.
Yes, everybody, we thank God.
Thank God. Make we quickly round up the newspaper headlines.
Say we come back again.
Then we thank God. We tell you now.
Olawale.
Up yeah. For the day. And bring our stranger. Where they for sit. Wale, as at the TikTok, NDLEA, National Drug Law Enforcement Agency, Oga Buba Marwa don't talk, say, for two months, they seized drug worth about 60 billion naira.
That money is too much.
60 billion naira.
For just a treatment.
For two months, they seized drugs.
Seized drugs.
They seized them. They were, you know, like cocaine, like heroin, like... Then when they cost them 60 billion naira, the Oga even talks, the Chemo even talks, part of all this criminal art or whatever, now 90% all this thing they happen for Nigeria, now drugs they cost them. Drugs, now they cost them. So that one, now that one. When I don't hear say yesterday, Sunday, early in the morning, about 8 a.m., Nine fire don't catch one of the buildings for Abuja, and the people complain bitterly. They say when the fire started in the morning, begin raise. Then the people begin call fire brigade. Due to the as people take complain, they say some fire brigade they no come in time. Some will come in time they no carry water. Some will carry water no. they no miss the thing, you understand? So. Than a Nigeria for you. But sometimes the Oga Pata Pata for fire service, they talk, say, they're not be magic maker. When you go just talk, fire they burn, no, they go just fly on there. It's impossible can't. You understand? Fire they burn, no, we don't appear. When be say, not be, no. The Oga talk, say, it not be like that. Our government, they tell new doctors, then when they employ, they talk, say, make them know, follow all those people when one talk about strike, join any strike. Those new doctors, our government, they tell them. People say they don't employ them, and they tell them, say, anything like strike, make a common hand for inside strike. You hear say, Lassa fever, don't kill. Lassa fever, it don't kill. And 92,432 don't they hospitalize. Lassa fever. That even they keep as COVID.
Yes.
But they know too much put an eye. You see, Lassa fever. They keep as COVID, you understand? May God help us. May God help us. Then for Ogun State, they say artisan. For Ogun State artisan. For inside hotel, there, one of the guests for inside hotel is stabbed to death. As he stabbed and finished, He talks in a devil. He talk like against devil. Devil self don't tire. Oh, this switch. Devil don't tire. And I tell you, devil, he go meet Baba God. When he reach there, God, he say, devil won't come fight so that he go destroy. But before devil reach there, he lie down for God. He say, God, I beg, help me tell your people. This one thief, he go say, devil. This one coming, you go say devil. You rape, you go say devil. He say make it happen.
No, devil. That one
a personal. Hey, personal that, thing. Yes, somebody.
It just a lie on top devil.
Well, now so that paper you see. Well, you hear something, get something when I hear and when the post come from London about this COVID something. You go do test. Wait, say you want travel.
Yes, I hear that thing.
Eh?
Yeah.
You won't go do the test.
After you don't collect vaccine already.
Uh-huh.
So you won't go do test again. They will tell you say you dey positive. How possible?
Okay, they will say you dey positive.
Yes, after you don't collect the vaccine for Nigeria, you don't collect normal vaccine.
Okay.
So they want to say you test positive.
Okay, they will talk say you test positive, Abby. doctor say test
yes.
positive.
After you take collect the vaccine.
Okay, not be smart, you know. Make everybody watch out. Una no understand. Make una watch out. And this, if they travel, you reach there. Maybe the first test you they put for test you. Come say you test negative. The next day they come again say you test yeah, positive. Be careful. Be careful. You understand that? Be careful. Things they happen. Things they happen. That one I will take round up the paper style for today, the paper headlines for today. The thing we'll get to talk for today, because our guests there, they don't they run. Our guests don't they run. But make we just throw the question down, then we'll go upstairs there, we'll go up, go bring one of our guests, yes. Talk to them, we'll continue again. The thing now about this hiking price of transportation. Why be say for this festive period the price of transportation can't go up? Why? What is the reason? People not even get sympathy on people. You yeah. don't have mercy on even virtual na the whole Nigeria. If all these big transport transporters, transport organizations, their money don't high. Those where they collect 5,000 before na 10. Those where they collect 10 now 15. Why be say we not be behave like other people? We be say even make it be in a festive period. Make things where would they do? Like price of food, transportation, everything. Make it come down. Nothing of such. So before our government then go put motor down. Because they say before our government go put motor down. I don't know whether that food don't cause. I mean diesel don't cause. You understand? Before you go here, say one of the state government put motor down for those people who won't travel, who won't go somewhere. But now, this December, I never hear them at all. Now that thing with it shook much put today, hiking price of transportation during festive period. For this season, some people know if you go home.
Yes,
some people,
yes,
you
yes,
can't
yes,
try
yes,
it.
Yes, yes,
some know if you travel. Some where they are placed far, no fit travel because of this money. There's one thing again. As I said, Lagos driver, they like money. Especially you could do where we did here. Go do driver, they like money. Make people plenty for bus stop. The money don't hide with that.
No.
I like Lagos driver, they get talent. Their talent is to increase money. Increase money on human beings. You understand?
They can call you. They can call you from Mexico. They can
no,
buy 100.
No. You feel they for K2. It don't happen to me. Are they for K2? Are they come to Ikorodu? They say K2. Ikorodu 100 naira. I can't say whether I go fit get one with less. Until Ikorodu 200 come, now 100 naira in my pocket too. Until Ikorodu 300 come, I can't define standing. I define standing. May God help us. Alright, God help us. So now the thing we go they pull out today. Hiking price of transportation. Waiting the cost them. Shena for an in course or this will cost during this festive period. When are supposed to help somebody. Remember say if you help somebody, God too go help you.
Yes.
Wally, make we go upstairs there. If we come back, we go carry the first guest we'll get. Carry and come inside. Will they come back? No shake. Right? Welcome back to the program. Solab TV 9 be this. My name still remain normal, Laja Tonsoba. And I know as we take duam every time like this, our guests don't sit down for inside house. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, and those with the Nigeria here, those with the abroad, join me as I welcome Prophet Ola Nij.
Revival Evangelical Church, Aka Garden of Safe Harbor.
Okay, now that you the pastor, Abi?
Yes, okay. By the grace of God.
Okay, that's fine. Before God call you for these programs, before God call you.
Yes.
What did they do before?
Well, we thank God though. There was a time I was doing 3 jobs at the same time.
Okay, at the time?
Yes. Okay. When I left school, I went to primary school. From primary school to secondary school. From secondary school, then I did some high institution at home.
Okay.
You know where?
Part-time, Abi.
Yes, part-time. Where parents no get money.
Okay. You go to push them.
Struggle. Make we just go school.
So that then, you mark your register.
Then later, I'll do vendor.
Okay, that's
selling
one.
Selling paper.
Okay, so those people they do poop. That's vendor. The vendor.
That was when Nigeria was still.
When Nigeria did good, where
yes,
were?
Yes, not
when if you take 20 naira, cook rice and soup.
20 naira, okay. Now small money there. Then at that time, at the same time, at the land work, so I got out to sell paper. Mm-hmm. I was the manager then that would distribute paper.
Okay.
So the day I left that job, where I know say it was my job, I wake 3 a.m. in the midnight.
Okay.
So I thought it's 5. So I prepare for office. So all the trousers I wear, everything, it was turned down.
Okay.
So I'm getting to a job to pay now. Then I see I couldn't no money.
Okay.
And then the people were looking at me and said, God, what's wrong with you now? I said, I wake, I don't know. It is not 5. That day, I came back home. So I have to surrender everything for God.
To God, okay.
So let me do the work of God now. So since God is calling me.
Okay.
This one I'm telling you now is around 80s, 87, 88.
Then how somebody take God call him? How you take no hear? People say, God call me. Oh. Because sometimes some pastor will say, I heard the voice of God now. I hear God tell me this one. Say, make people drop this one. Make people pay this money. Make, how then they take care of? Because we say we human being.
Well, the first way, if you want to know that God is calling you, this God, he has the way he speaks to
different
people.
Methods.
Different methods.
Okay.
Like my own now, the first time he speak to me, it was on dream.
Okay.
It was on dream. I had the dream very clearly with the date. 3-4-1989. I can't forget. 1989. That I see the vision clearly. Then God spoke to me. So after 1989, that I mix with them. So when I mix with them, then tell them this is what I see. Then they now tell me again to go and pray.
Okay, to go and pray after you don't see that thing.
Yes, I went back again to pray. Again, God still spoke with me. Then God sent people to me again. For confirm. So it's not like when you say some people are saying, I hear the voice of God today. Well, the way people hear the voice of God, now them sabi.
But some people now then they hear the voice of stomach more than the voice of God.
Actually.
Because some people now their belly call them.
Well.
Maybe through hungry and whatever. They decide to open. Say money day for pastorals and pastors. They open.
If anybody say my belly call me because you see.
Yeah, but they're not gonna talk say belly call them.
But at the time when the challenges come, it will show.
Okay.
It will show. The work of God is not what you can just sit down and say, like I'm not like Jeton Shayibo is doing this one. I must do it. No.
Make them not say talk self, no days.
No, you know easy. You know easy at all. Mm. If you because of maybe this one have money, maybe they are hearing this one. This one is riding deep. And you say God call you when the challenges come, you will know that God does not call you. Mm. Because any vision that God does not give, okay, he will not implement it.
Okay, fine. But
he will not.
Thank you very much. Mm. I want to know, under who? Many of the pastors, when they come here, if I mention under who ordained you, then go talk.
Christ Apostolic Church.
Like ordained. Under who? Who ordained you? Then is
Christ Apostolic Church ordained me.
Christ Apostolic Church.
Yes.
Okay, they put
I was a choir master in Christ Apostolic Church.
Choir master.
Yes.
Sir, you are going to sing here. You must sing. And our producer, if you sing, producer with you be choir master.
So my pastor then, of a blessed memory now, is late Baba Amusan, Pastor Michael Oluamusan.
Okay.
He tutored me. I was the choir master under him, as the choir master for years before God was calling me. Yeah, the day I went to him and I said,
Amusan,
he tutored me. I was the choir master under him, as the choir master. I know before you come and tell me that God is calling you. So, but I want God to speak to you.
Sir, as a choir master, that hand, when are they do like you? Now they learn now.
Yes, now.
That hand, when I do,
That's music. Music on its own. Sir, it is Nigeria of today, or let me say the children of today. You can't just, no one man is an island. You cannot just wake up today and say, I don't become a guy.
Okay, you must go through.
No. There must somebody. You may have gift. When you have gift, you subdue yourself under somebody. They will tutor you.
Okay, you go bow under.
Yes, spirit bow for spirit.
Okay, like so, Iron Sharpened Iron.
Yes, so they will tutor you. This is the way you can do it. This is the way you can do it. This is the way you can do it. Many will say, no, I don't have master. It is the Holy Spirit.
No.
They will fumble later.
Okay, they go.
They will fumble. When you have the Holy Spirit as your teacher, you still have to have another person that mentors you.
Sir, thank you very much. The person one that is still here is Prophet Olaniyi, and today he starts to do here with me, Omol Lajeton. So, but we're there for Solar Television. The corner windows in the interview part of Solar Television. We they continue, Pastor. Since when you don't start this, when God don't call you, even before God call you, have you enter? You don't enter moto one day. The days of Molue begin preach.
Yes.
That? Maybe from Songo to Oshodi, then from Oshodi to Ikorodu. Because I don't see some people when don't give us this money, say they don't pray for example to Taya.
Actually, in that area, there are some people that are giving that ministry.
Okay.
Not I am a pastor, I must preach in Molue. Not every
pastor. Not everybody.
There are some people, they are giving the ministry. You can go to the hospital. Some can go to prison yards. Some can go to rehabilitations. Some can be in the box. In any different kinds, you can preach the gospel.
Okay, in any way.
In any way. In anywhere. At anywhere.
Thank you, sir.
It depends on how you are called, how you are given the ministry.
Sir, since you don't start this, the way God don't call you.
Yes, sir.
People, they call you to come preach. Come preach for my church.
Actually,
Abi.
Yes.
And tell me one thing where you don't face one day, where you go preach, where you don't like. I don't face this one. This one I don't face before. Well, as I won't go preach when I don't like.
Well, there was a time when I started early of the ministry that I can't forget. We went to a vigil. At that time, if I would be given a salary then, a month, it would be when I early of the ministry when I started early of the ministry that I can't forget we went to a vigil. At that time,
marathon fasting.
Yes, 3 days. So then we were coming back home after the vigil. So when it was raining, the rain was about to fall. So I paid for 3 of us out of 4 naira. I paid 3 naira.
You remain one naira.
So I was thinking that that 1 naira, I will use it to buy anything for me to break. But when we alert, that when we come down from motor, so I have just to cross through. Then it was breeze, rain. Then I keep running. Along the line when I was running to break, 1 naira fell in my pocket.
Okay, it fell down. Not because they pick him for inside motor.
Fall.
Okay, but you know, it fall down.
It fall. So I don't know where the 1 naira fell.
Breeze go down carry him.
So rain has to beat me and get home.
But when when the money dropped, it takes time to find out.
I didn't know now.
Okay.
I was running because rain.
Which means say if they pick and for inside the motor when you enter you.
I don't know.
Yes, okay. Yes.
If it is outside, I don't know.
Okay.
But I just know that the 1 hour has lost. So when I get home now, I was searching. I couldn't find the 1 hour again. No food, nothing to eat, no any other place, nothing. Then I just said, well, since you are the person that is calling me, if you like, let me feed. So it was, then I slept off. So when I woke now, it was around the day, the evening. That day, God just sent a man to me. And he said, God said, I should come and give you this. Come and give you this.
That's manna. Solar Television 9 minutes. And they here with Prophet Olani.
Yeah.
Prophet, yeah. You don't talk the negative side of it. Make me hear, since when God don't call you, wait till you go to say, I don't enjoy you.
Well, about the enjoyment, to be sincere, God is good. Let me just use a language to say it, that there is no day that God has disappointed me. If it's getting worse as a man,
it will surprise you.
God will come up.
It will rise.
Since he has called me, that he said, if you agree to do this work that you are doing now, that you agree to put every other things aside and work, I will not disappoint you. Till today, he has never.
That's God for you.
Yes. He has. So I enjoy him. But, you know, when I start, I didn't know now. So, because I didn't have somebody to help me, and from, let me use the word, poor family.
Okay,
so, you know, some people are born with the spoon in their mouth, but like myself.
Okay, they struggle to bring the spoon.
Now,
Prophet, yes. So, Prophet, before we go break,
yes.
Before we go break, we'll come back and round up what they do.
Yes.
Make a quickly tell people, say, you get a chance to call Prophet Olani, the number where you take call there for the screen.
Yes.
Just say, Pastor, hello, you understand? And salute and Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. I believe, say, you are members then they watch you for this program. I believe, say, then all of them, they see. Because, Prophet.
Yes, sir.
Before we go break, and when we go come back on round, you talk one thing.
More than the cockroach, the humaya. All things are passed away. I'm a new man.
Oh, now, Prophet, if they make I rate you for this song, I will rate you 70%. You know the rest 30%. Where you go. You know why I'm not going to give you? You know, throw your hand. Now,
well, actually, train of hand comes to when choirs are singing.
Okay, when you are standing. When you are standing.
So, Amalajeto, so Ibo is controlling me.
Well, Prophet, you get one thing when I hear, you see?
Okay.
Maybe you'll be choir master. You're just single. So, you look for somebody to marry. But now, you go take that hand control. They or stand choir. Well, then you take out. Boy, shape our world, flock by night, la 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 la. You go tell the boy, that girl where you did that. I want to see you,
No.
I want to see you,
no,
after the church service.
No. That is not a gospel.
It's not gospel. It's a comedy, I mean. My producer, make me go upstairs. Will they come back? Will they come? Right, welcome to the program, Pastor Prophet Olani. Pastor, you're welcome.
Thank you.
You're welcome, sir. Thank I talk say anybody we want call Prophet. Our numbers they for scream number one, number two. They for scream there to call Prophet to ask some questions. I know say in church member, Pastor, we're just if I say we're a church, they just mention the place, no mention address. Because of one thing or the other.
We are in Ikorodu here. Just okay, Ikorodu.
Thank
here.
God. I'm waiting in the name of the church.
Revival Evangelical Church.
Revival Evangelical Church.
Yes.
You say after this program, you're going to bring your advert.
By special here. Grace of God.
Yes,
by
yes.
Special. Already, yes. I don't become the family of exactly. The network.
So if you come here, come preach 30 minutes, 15 minutes, and give to people to win people's soul. But Pastor, let's talk about this winning of soul.
Yes,
how they take the one. Are you the go out and be members there to go outside? Yeah, our pastor say you, God they invite you, will they do this, do that, too. How do I take that?
Thank you very much. It's a good question I love. Preaching of gospel to everybody is to everybody that believes in Jesus Christ.
Okay.
But the mistake that people are making is the pastor alone.
Okay.
The pastor is to nurture people that give their life to Christ and lead them. So to preach the gospel, it's for everybody.
Because the Bible says, go ye to the world.
Everybody.
And preach.
Every. Even normal, like that, also evil.
That's what we are doing.
Yes.
I'll do it this
so
way.
Everybody. Everybody, anywhere, anytime.
Because, Pastor, you tell me the other time, you say, God called everybody in a different way.
Yes.
God take all everybody.
Yes.
Some go there for pulpit.
Yes.
Some nice time mulu and go do
it. Yes.
Some this and my own here nice side.
Exactly.
Yes.
But the problem that many people don't know is that they don't know exactly where they are called to.
Okay. They
that
don't
is why
know
you see
the department.
Many, yes. So you're supposed to know where
because
you are called
all,
to.
Everyone get department.
Exactly.
Like in a company. There's what they call division of labor.
In everywhere.
In fashion.
We learned that in school.
Yes, division of labor.
Yes, in any
one,
company where there is no division of labor, the leader will labor and die prematurely.
Okay, there must be a division of labor in...
In everywhere, even in the pastorship.
Okay, division of labor.
There is.
As in, pastor go preach. That's where they prepare the...
everywhere. The choir has its own department.
Okay.
The ushering has its own department. The Sunday school teacher, the preacher, and the counselor, everywhere. So everybody is for edifying. That means to bring the body of Christ
together
and to nurture it.
I like that.
So, but many people did not know. Many will say, God has called me. And I want to, I'm going to the whole world. Hey, I don't have a house. It's a mistake. It's a mistake. So we need to sit down and learn about the world, know exactly where God called you to, and do exactly the job that God will call you.
Yeah, Pastor, as you this, I want to ask you, sometimes maybe wrongfully because we be human being. You vest, maybe then you can't remember say, ah, this is my do so no, wait till you
they happen sometimes.
I actually, or you, a man that is born of flesh,
okay,
must at least once. But the Bible even say, don't go angry, but don't allow the sun to set on your anger.
Okay.
And there is something we don't know.
Which means sometimes you feel vexed.
When you say somebody is vexed, when you say somebody is vexed, somebody can vex.
Okay.
When you vex, when you did not do anything, that means
is it not a sin?
To vex is not a sin. The action of verse.
Okay, the thing will follow verse.
If I verse now and I verse, then I slap somebody.
Okay.
That is sin.
Okay, it's a sin. But,
if I verse, the thing verse me and I didn't say anything.
Okay.
It is normal for everybody. But when you verse and you react, maybe you carry somebody or carry something and knock it on person. No.
But is the idea? Pastor will verse for somebody when no tell her. Say, see the thing what you do.
To tell the person the way you verse for. The Bible says we should tell that person.
But some people,
this is what you do.
But some people don't get that kind of. They say if you do that something,
no,
they talk him.
No.
Go just they're not going to talk him, but they don't finish for their mind.
No. They're supposed to call you and tell you so that you will not repeat that thing again that you do. So that you will not do it again. So they will call you and tell you, say, this thing where you do is not good. I don't like it too. Then when that person says sorry,
okay,
it's finished.
Let me know about your matrimonial home. How many children? One come and follow more. Children come and damn go. Because all of them.
To the glory of God, I'm happily married. My wife should have been here because they went for an assignment. So
okay. What's her name?
She's also a pastor. Pastor Mrs. Oluremi Olani.
Okay, because I asked one question here one day when one pastor come, he never answered me.
Okay.
And I will continue to ask until I see someone will answer me the question.
Okay.
See, I say, if I see somebody sign board, I will see mommy and daddy. Mm. Mommy and daddy.
Okay.
Then but if somebody will be pastor, when wife no come be, you see, waiting will happen. Does it have anything to do?
Well, about that. Let me use the word, we are individual differences. Like myself and others, you will never see a sambod, see my photo, see my wife, and see the other.
Okay.
Some people don't like it.
Okay, not they put sambod.
Naturally, they don't like it. They just put the name of the church.
Okay.
Then there are some people there that only him will be there. Okay. The wife will not be there.
But the wife is a pastor. Fine.
They may do it for reasons. Many reasons. Because I spoke with one day, one said he cannot do it. I cannot be showing my wife, showing myself and showing my wife for security reasons. Some don't do it.
Pastor, I won't ask you this question. I never asked somebody before.
Okay.
I won't ask you this question.
Okay.
When would they grow up that time? White garment church.
Okay.
We as a woman, not they climbed on top of water.
Yes.
But this time around, you see woman preaching on altar. Well, she church that time don't different from this time. They're not follow that doctrine again.
Not even only white garment church alone. That the women don't climb the altar.
Uh-huh.
There are still some churches up to today.
Okay.
That it's like that. But there are some churches that their women climb the altar. What I just want to say in that area is. Quote on the leader. Because when it comes to a stage, when you are telling people or you say something, some people will tell you, what I am doing is God say that I should do it. So if they say God say women should come to their altar, you have nothing to do about that.
You should hold them responsible.
So it is on the leader.
So in one way or the other, we should use that Shakespeare book when I say as you like it.
You
like it, as they like them. That's the language.
Let we use that language as they will.
Okay.
As they will.
Okay.
Because
as they will
some will say God says.
God say. Yes, God talks say.
When anybody say God talk say, they go ask you, say you see that God to go question that God. So it depends on that person.
So that
if God says.
Sir,
if God did not say.
I still bring you back to your
Madam, you are talking about Madam.
Okay.
She's a pastor.
Yes, she's a preacher. Okay. By the special grace of God, she will still come here, even to preach.
By the grace of God. And we would like to receive her too. You say her name is...
Oluremi Olani.
Oluremi Olani. How are your children going?
My children are doing fine. They are in school.
Yes, fine. We thank God.
They are in school.
Then which advice you get for those people whenever accept God?
Thank you very much. My advice is just to come to Christ. When we are talking of miracles, many people can do many miracles. But I am talking of salvation.
Ibala.
When we are talking of salvation, salvation is in Christ Jesus. And that's Acts chapter 4 verse 12. So, know any other person that can give you salvation except Jesus. Hallelujah. Because after this world, either we like it or not, you get money, you go die.
You don't get money.
You get money, you go die.
You
chop, be hungry.
You chop. You
ride car.
You don't wear clothes.
You don't ride car. You do this.
Then why you come to park plenty car over there? Come build house there. And you're not going to sleep
you
too.
You go die one
only
day.
One bed.
But if anybody died there without Jesus,
hey,
it's a great loss.
No problem. Oh.
Here on earth and in heaven. And to the young ones that are coming in the work, let them be patient for their time. I think you will ask me that for how many years have I been doing? Since January 1989.
You're talking for years.
1989. Yes. That I have started. So before I start on my own, I have Oga, the father, I swear
and
they follow.
And go fast, saute.
Yes.
Sir, even if they call you and I say no chop for 40 days, you go. No. Because I see some pastors, I have some pastors' friends, they go soon come to this program. And they do 150 days. Fasting.
Actually, if you don't want to add juju to the work of God, you must fast. You must pray.
If you don't want to add that for sure.
If you don't want to add small juju, small God.
You go fast.
You need fast.
Praise the Lord.
Fast. Pray. Word of God. That is the three weapon that you can be succeed.
You get one song, say, Christian, seek not yet repose.
Yes. Yes. Hear what the angel is saying. Yes. That the King of Kings. You are in the midst of the enemy. Be watchful.
Watchful. Watch and pray.
So, must watch.
Well, now, Prophet Olani, you are here, so Prophet Olani, now the Prophet Olani, lastly here,
thank
you. Can I say, which advice do you give for our Nigerian leaders? What you go tell them?
Well, I am just advising the Nigerian leaders that God be with them. Let me first pray for them, that God guide them, protect
Amen.
Them.
Amen.
Because to be a leader is not easy. To be a leader is not easy. But I am appealing to the leaders, they should come back to God. They can do all things successfully. They can provide for everybody. That is when God is leading them.
Oh, thank you.
When they allow the leading of God. It will be good.
Thank you. This Nigeria, it will be good.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Your name again?
I'm Prophet Olani Ebenezer Hajibade Olani.
From?
Revival Evangelical Church in Ikorodu here.
Sir, now you don't hear so. Prophet Olani. I believe say next time again, Prophet Olani, you go there here with me. You go even they preach for this station.
Yes.
When we finish, all those ones we go put them in place as you go take the hear them. They discharge. They say, I banned you. I cast you. I destroy you, devil, in the mighty name of Jesus. Mm-hmm. So now, so this one go be. If we go upstairs, come back, we go carry another Ogbonge pastor. We get Bishop David Adeleke in there for house. So make we go up. If we come back, now Bishop could be here with me, Bishop David Adeleke. And they come back, may not come out. All right, welcome back to the program, Solar Television 9 minutes. My name is still remain normal, Lajetun Soibo. No forget, I say Tom by Tom PSC 9 minutes, please. Everywhere when are they here also? When are they watch us? Nigeria, London, UK, and everywhere we see the we dey brekete, brekete. Labota, now in the talk. I said the tallest broadcaster so far. We don't know as we take the one. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, join me as I welcome Pastor Bishop David Adeleke in the studio. Bishop!
Thank you very much.
Bishop, you're welcome, sir.
Thank you.
Bishop, 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 Bishop. Bishop, where up. Bishop, Bishop, you give us some time. Bishop, from Monday, last week, Bishop will come today. Waiting happen. Bishop, waiting
go
happen.
Go to the mountain, organizing the programs, Christmas, end of the year program. Like we have service tonight, we have program, end of the year program. Titled Ashanogu Empty Handed. So we are preparing for that one.
I know to catch you now, to get you now, not this.
I'm sorry, it's not my fault. Yes, now I'm here.
Bishop, before I get to I go call Bishop because I'm on like Bishop.
I'm here now.
Bishop, let's start with prayer. Maybe we start with prayer.
Let us pray. Father in heaven, we just thank you.
We thank you, Lord.
We thank you, Lord, for preserving us from the beginning of the year till now.
We thank you, Lord.
We thou glorify in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, we thank you for all the hearers that are hearing us.
We thank you.
Every eyes that are seeing us. We pray that their eyes are blessed.
Amen.
Even their lives are blessed.
Amen.
Even as we proceed in this program, oh Lord, let your presence abide with us.
Amen.
As the word is going now, let power follow the word.
Amen. Amen.
In the name of Jesus. Amen. At the end of everything, take all the glory.
Amen.
For in Jesus' name we are praying.
Amen.
Praise and, God.
Hallelujah. And Bishop, una the years. Bishop. Bishop. Bishop, has some time. Bishop, yes. I don't see you preach before, honestly. But this prayer come gently, not by fire.
You know, this is studio now. Okay, when we get to the place of deliverance, we know that we must slap the devil.
Slapping the devil, that'll be your first.
This studio, and then, like you told us, they say this is an international studio, so we cannot...
international people they watch.
We have to do it in a very decent manner.
Exactly.
So but when we get to the war front, we know
to face
fight.
The devil, somebody must be violent.
The Bible says in the day of John the Baptist,
the kingdom of God, somebody violent.
And only the violent are taken
by force. Hallelujah.
But that's the time when you want to address the people. Mm-hmm. You know, you come gently, you know. Yes, but when we get to the war front,
to destroy them.
Yes, like this afternoon now, we have a deliverance session.
Okay.
And that will be like from 4 o'clock. It's going to be fire.
So to face devil, not be smart.
It's not be smart, you know. Somebody who wants to face devil. You must be hot.
Sir, but you know, say devil self don't tire for people. Devil go meet God the other day.
Don't,
say God, I
don't,
beg you.
Don't,
they, yeah,
don't
the devil
make,
is tired.
Don't make a mistake.
Devil don't tire don't, for.
Devil know they tire.
He go meet God, say come, God I beg. He lie down for God, say
no,
Baba.
You
he call God
care.
Baba.
Oh,
he say
God.
Baba. You see people, this one commit. He go say devil. This one thief. Devil. This one commit. This one. He say help me beg your people.
Yeah. Oh, you don't know the devil. Devil
no,
know the time.
No, no. Sometimes human being can be devil on their own.
Of course, you know. So you know, this devil we are saying. You know, the highest level of manifestation of devil is when he enter human being. When he use human being to manifest what he wants to do.
Oh, wonderful. Okay.
Okay, since we are born, have you seen devil? Like
unless that one when they look for inside the book of my Bible story.
Then you can only see in the book. But when you want drunk. To see devil in manifestation, now human being will see.
Okay, now human being.
Because devil must enter inside human being or something living to manifest. That is it.
Thank you very much.
That is it.
Sir. Who be Bishop David?
Kuro like
unless that one when they look for inside the book of my Bible story.
God, that God called for many years, ran away from the call, self. So
run away from
the call. Somebody knows how some people that God, when God called them, that some people God didn't even call them.
Okay.
They just desired this work of God.
Okay. Their stomach called them.
I don't want to say stomach. Some people just decide not be said stomach.
Okay,
it's not everybody.
Stomach
call. That stomach call. Some people just like pastor work.
Okay.
Like some children when they are in school, they just like to
passion,
because of a wig and gown, they like law.
Okay.
They want to be lawyer. Some people, because you know, pastor they wear coat now.
Okay.
They say they want to become pastor. Some people, because of caste, of, they say they want to become reverend.
Okay.
But me, I don't like that kind of thing. The thing where I like is a different thing entirely.
Okay.
So now, in the midst of that one, God now say, make I come do the work.
Okay.
Now, God, me and God, we fight wrestling.
God can't call you.
God called me, and I knew that God called me.
Sir, before God call you, what do they do? Who you be?
You know, my call was I was just graduating from school.
Okay.
When God called me.
You don't tell.
Yes. I've already done military training.
Yes,
full military training.
Navy or soldier.
Nigerian Army. Yes. Then I've already graduated as a quantity surveyor.
On Nigerian Army?
Yeah. No,
okay,
I went to secondary school but trained by the Army. So it was at that point of decision that the call came. But then I didn't yield. But because I didn't yield, God didn't allow many things to work for me. I have some plans. Even the military, something, everything just turned upside down.
Okay, just like...
So I just find myself, I still said, me, this call, I will not do it. Because I didn't want to be a pastor.
Okay, they run for God.
I began to do business. So I began to do the business. I would do it big, but it will go up or it will come down. You know, I'm not the kind of people that will say, because God has called me, that's why my business is not working. But what my eyes saw, I cannot say it. So I was in the midst of that, where I said, okay, maybe if I began to serve God small,
mm-hmm.
maybe God will be blessing me. God will just give this call matter.
Small.
God will just leave this call matter. I began to join one church or the other. The moment they want to give me higher responsibility, I go dodge.
Oh.
So there I enter the Dean Christian Church of God. You know their own, it's not easy to dodge.
No.
The moment they catch you like this, and they know, say, call Dave your head, they go use you. So that was how we started the ministry. Because I've been running from church to church. I ran from from Baptist. Mm-hmm. I went to Lateran.
But you could gain something.
I was gaining something. I was rising. They were seeing me. The thing is, even if I say, okay, this church where I want to enter now, I don't go allow them to see me. They go still see me.
They go see. Yeah.
No matter how
God.
And now God, they reveal me now. Even if I hide like this, they give me so many responsibilities. I wanted to run, I don't feel wrong.
You don't choke.
I don't choke. Oh, the thing choke. Oh, he choke. Oh.
He choke. Oh.
Now, so I dey hook. Oh. Now, so I say, okay. Meanwhile, I see they do my business. So, as I was doing my business, now God, they flog me for business. But anything where I do for ministry, it go work. Anything I do for ministry like this, it go work.
Then aside ministry.
Aside ministry like this, I go achieve very na me go do am. But anything I do for ministry, for church, not be me they do am, but they work. But anything for where not be church, outside the ministry,
yes.
I go achieve oh, but na me go do am. You know, if you are the one doing the thing, you go work. Oh. You go work hard. You go slave. But even our God, the Duam, it doesn't matter what they call autopilot.
Wonderful.
Autopilot, automation. Maybe say you go, you need to effort like this. So after I don't try, now I did tire. I say, look, why am I even running away from this thing? Let me
from your responsibility.
Let me
go. Make you carry your cross.
I carry my cross.
Mm.
And the thing they work, there's no church where they put me, where no go grow. They put me to church, maybe say, they no cuckoo thing, say the God, the church go work.
All right. Now, Bishop David Adeleke, here's the talking story. I take start. I take everything. Bishop, you're from which state?
I'm from Oyo State.
Oyo?
Oyo town.
Which side of Oyo?
Oyo town.
Oyo town?
Oyo town.
Oyo town.
Oyo Alafi.
Oyo Alafi.
That is where I came from. Yes. No matter how rain beat Shekere,
yes.
It will not be soft.
It will be
sandy.
Wonderful. First of all, you are born into the family of tell me more about your mom.
My father is a teacher.
Okay.
Retired teacher. My mother too. She's
a
trader. So they still there.
They still there.
Ironically, they are in their 80s now.
Okay.
So
they still there.
They still there.
Alive. We thank the Lord. Hallelujah.
And my family is slightly large. So.
Are they jealous of you? Mama day, Papa day.
They, but no, that one a responsibility now, but it's okay. I still enjoying the responsibility.
No, wonderful. Yeah, then Mama, Papa day.
The day.
Everybody day.
You know, once in a while you have to go and see them. It's a responsibility.
Once in a while you don't farm before, like you know, see those for
instance. Farm, you know, because I was not really a farm like that, but you see, I was not a farmer like that, but
you know, go school for that side.
When I, you know, Oyo is not a village.
Okay. But they must get bush.
They get bush, but you know, when you are just like this Lagos now, there are bushes in Lagos now. Mm-hmm. How many Lagosians are farming? Even if government in Lagos states, they are trying to promote farming. They pump a lot of money.
People, they bend their head.
Of course, but me, I had contact with farming because my father was being posted from village to village, from location to location. My father loves farming.
Okay. They carry on up and down.
They will carry us up and
just
down.
Just like my own father.
Yes. Too. So in the course of going to places, my father loved our passion for farming.
Okay.
So that one made me to get in touch with farm. So when I got to secondary school, because I went to modern school.
Okay. What is the name of your primary school?
My primary school is St. John Anglican Primary School. That one is in Ibadan. Then I attended I attended the Anglican Methodist Modern School. That one is in Oyo. Before I proceeded to the secondary school. You know, before I got to secondary school, I was already mature. You know, where you go to modern school.
That was those days. When I was in
modern school is like secondary.
I was looking
school.
At my son 11 years, he's in class 2. When I was 11 years, they primary 4.
So that modern school issue is, you know, you have become so grown up.
Mm.
But because they know today, they know that you are already mature, they will now place you in form 2. Well, we have, you know, that time there was no SS, GSS. You have only from 1 to 5.
Yeah.
But we that have gone to modern school, we place us in form 2. So when I got to secondary school, because of my contact with the farm and everything, I chose Agric as a subject.
Gotcha.
And that subject, I didn't need to read it because it's like I knew it.
Okay.
But I had A1 in it.
Wonderful.
Yes, because it's like a piece of cake. Yes.
Wonderful.
That was my contact with the farm. Mm-hmm. Not because I was raised in a farm like Oyo is a village. One of these days I will take Omo Laje to Oyo. Because you don't know Oyo. Oyo is a city.
I don't go Oyo. I don't do MC. I don't do MC 2-3 times for your stage.
Okay.
Even if they go around there, you understand?
Right.
I want to know about it. You talk something the other time. Mm. I won't bring you back to that. I don't hear them before.
Mm.
Say you do training for soldier training.
Yeah, very true.
How the because my daddy too. My daddy from a soldier, regional sergeant major, crossover to custom. I did tell people. So that one I they take me to run when I take here different kind of language for Nigeria. Yeah, when you do that training, see that time, is it different from now? That training they give that time.
You see, the military has so many paths to pursue the career. Even up to now, you know, they have what they call direct service. They have what they call short service called commission, direct service, and direct service combatant. We have what we call short service combatant. Then we have what we call direct short service combatant. So the short service combatant they were already graduates. They will now go for a short training. Then they commission them. Then the direct short service combatant, then they are this system that they used to admit them is officer cadet.
Okay.
Officer cadet is through a series of cadet course, you know. So when you are still in school, you'll be doing full military training. All the syllabus of military training. It depends from NMS, it depends from NDA. But when you finish, you still go and finish, you know, do a kind of orientation at NCT, and then you go to face the board.
Okay.
But that program, I think the army is no more pursuing it. In so many years, I think since the time of Abacha, the program has been suspended. They said they suspended it. So the aim of the military was that they want to have professionals for the as a reserve. Whenever they need professionals, they want to have them handy so that in case of war, they can call them in.
Thank you, sir. Make I know, because all the pastors when they bring here, they go say, "Now this one, now he ordained me. This one, now he ordained me." For you, who?
Well, I was ordained by Pastor E. Adeboye. I had all the ordinations of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. In the Redeemed Christian Church of God, when you are there, you start as a worker. You can't jump it.
Exactly.
Then you'll be ordained as a deacon. You can't jump it. You cannot jump so
those process.
Yes. Then you will be ordained as a time pastor AP, and all those stages level 4 years, 5 years apart. So then the highest ordination in the Redeemed Christian Church of God is full pastor, which I got also. I was ordained by Pastor E. Adeboye. So now it is after I have now been released by the Redeemed Christian Church of God over 10 years ago.
That release is a process again.
It's a process. So some people, when they want to go and start their own ministry, they abandon, they abscond. You know, those are the ones that say, they didn't release them. It's not like jumping out of the boat, out of the ship. Okay. But we didn't do like that.
You go through the normal process.
It's not easy because I don't think it's the policy of the ministry to be releasing people. But prayerfully and with patience, you can achieve it. Don't jump.
I like that.
Yes, don't jump with that. Because where are you rushing to? Is it not the work of God? In your business, if you go and do it and God doesn't follow you there, or the blessing doesn't follow you there, you will not be able to achieve it.
Sir, aside from this pastor, this job, there's another thing, because I see another thing again.
I told you that what I desired is to be a business person. What me I wanted. Because this pastor is not my idea. I don't like him. But I just have to agree.
God, that make I do your own.
No, I surrender.
Jesus, I surrender.
Just like answer. I just answer for God.
Oh, yeah, they use
because who can wrestle with God?
That's it. Sir, your music supposed to be carry me, they go. Jesus, carry me, they go, they go, they go.
So there's no how. Even when I say I want to do full-time ministry, because when I was being released, that over 10 years ago from the Redeemed Christian Church of God, my thinking was that, look, I will not even touch business anymore. The only thing I will be doing is this ministry. But I still discover that they do business. But one thing I discovered, since we started this ministry, anything I touched worked.
Go blow.
They blow. Anything I touched, they... So I now discover that what God was saying, and I didn't understand
now,
was that to start this ministry.
Now I know.
So since I started this ministry, there's nothing that I wanted that God has not done for me. So I now discovered that this is the destination. This is the plan of God. This is the future that God has ordained for me.
Thank you. Thank you now, Bishop David Adeleke. Now that they're here, so we're there for Solab Television here, live and direct for Lagos here. Bishop, if you come back, I go to ask you other things may remain because at the see school, at the see this,
and
this,
they and
here now. If we come back, make we go see our producer. Will they come back? Will they come back?
right, welcome back to the program Solar Television 9 Minutes. My name still remain Omo Lajetun Soibu. Don't forget to say today is my birthday.
Eh?
Today, the 27th day of December 2021. Today is my birthday.
Congratulations, Omo
Lajetun. Today is my birthday. But I will still talk, maybe if I'm, maybe when Pastor done, I will say today is my birthday, December 27th. So people, they expect me to talk up, and I will still talk up. But we still there for pastors and parody call. We there for the call. The segment we do soon at the call.
Yes.
Pastor, and we there here with Bishop David Adeleke. Yes. Bishop, make I ask you something. From pastor to reverend, from reverend to bishop. Yes. How is it? How is
you
it?
See, when you after you have been a pastor for some time, and you are doing, God is helping you. The work is going on well. The process, the colleges of bishops, the ordained reverend and bishops. So that was how I was called into the College of Bishops.
How easy?
It was not particularly, because it's not on the streets. It was not easy like that, but there are fathers. No, there are fathers in the ministry that will see your work, that will see that, you are qualified for this. They will propose to the college. The college will come and examine you. They will test you. You know, they will check what you are doing.
Okay.
So if you are qualified, you'll be
go ahead.
You'll be admitted to the College of Bishop. When you are now admitted, they will now come and consecrate you as a bishop.
So, break that English. Consecration.
To be, or some people call it enthronement as a bishop. You know, bishop. The process of bishop is not ordinary pastor.
That is, I was talking to you on phone. Yeah. I say cardinal. I say, ah! He say, won't make my neck break.
That was too heavy. You know, some people trivialize all these things, but they are not as trivial as people look at it. So they are very heavy. So you don't take it for granted.
Okay.
Like in our own College of Bishop, they will tell you that if you do not take a title that you cannot defend.
Wonder.
Yes.
No, okay, so there are some title you cannot defend
it when you don't have anything on ground and you want to go and be a bishop. You don't have people, don't have a church.
Just call it bishop.
Just call it bishop.
With a beer.
On Facebook. You're a bishop on Facebook.
Tell us about maybe physical church and Facebook church. How is it compare and contrast?
Well, I don't know. But we are in the age of internet now.
Okay.
Some people run their churches on Facebook. But I think
and the thing they match on.
Well, they match on, but
we are moving forward.
But when you see the result on ground, then you now match it up with Facebook. When you are not, they say charity begins at home. That should be something on ground, you know.
Exactly.
Some people they just use Facebook to camouflage to say they have something on ground. Let people visit your church and see what you have on ground. Then you can now broadcast it to outside the world. Just be a Facebook pastor.
Bishop, I want to ask you something. I see you get school.
Well, God gave us school.
School day.
It's part of the ministry now. You know, education is a ministry.
School day.
You know.
And I can call you for that school. Is it better to call you? Is it principal or proprietor?
No, I'm the proprietor, the chairman of the board of the school.
Then so how do they combine bishopism and probatory?
In whatever, because
as you say, so plenty things
there for your head. You know, I've learned my lesson the very hard way. So in all I do, this bishopric office takes priority. The work of God takes priority. And for the school, our own is just to formulate policy, give them direction.
What do you mean, name of your school?
Fruitville Schools.
Okay.
We have about three schools. We have the North School, we have the primary, we have the college. So our own is to give them direction, to give them policies, to provide financing.
Okay, to bring...
Yes, harmonize resources. That's just it.
Then other people
are doing... We have a lot of... We have heads that are heading it. We have principals, we have...
Division of Labor.
Yeah, Division of Labor. We have an administrator that's very able. So all those... even when I'm not there, the school is running smoothly. But the ministry, I make sure that I present myself. Despite the fact that I have pastors, I have a lot of pastors that are working with me. So I make sure that one, because There is no excuse. So. Okay. I don't want him to flog me again.
So people they fear God came.
No, that was, you know, David said, you know, when God gave David options that will he, you know, fall into the hands of the enemy or will he endure these three options. David said, look, let me fall into the hand of God. God is merciful.
Exactly. So, than in the hand of
the hand of my enemy.
Our Bishop David Adeleke and I will be here. So if you want to call Bishop to say hello, the number there for screen. Just check your screen, check your anything where you hold the screen or whatever. Check and you go see the number. Begin to call. Bishop, they much around here, they here, they play. And because you know they easy to catch Bishop. That's why we go see delay Bishop. We go delay Bishop here till 6 p.m.
I'm programming the church.
Bishop, we go delay here till 6 p.m.
I'm programming the church.
Yeah, that's why we go delay to
see. I have to steal time.
Bishop, that is why we delay you to 6 p.m. So that you tell them that people, they almost like delay you.
No.
Thank God.
I really appreciate your.
Bishop, make I ask this one. Madame Nko.
Madame D.
Madame D. Tell me a little story. Family.
Madame is okay. Madame is the administrator of the school. And
this is Madame
she's,
Go.
She's a co-pastor in the church.
Okay.
So, you know, we normally do our things, division of labor. While I'm here now, she's doing some other things. We have to share. Say, and madam, she's publicity shy a bit. She doesn't like to all this.
But with the drum.
All this television thing. But anyways, eventually, she will begin to follow suit.
Okay.
Yes, eventually.
What about Amonko?
Amawa, God has blessed her with children, and they are okay. They are grown up.
They are grown up.
I think my last child is. SS3 now. Graduating from SS3.
He's
one of the students in my school.
Can you mention the names?
The first one is Ayodele. Ayodele is an engineer. I have Koredes, who is a lawyer. Just finished master's in Unilag. Feluwa is an engineer too. She finished her own degree from Covenant University. I have Busola Adeleke. The lady too, then the last one, which is in the SS3.
Long ago. Madame Go, Verso, you don't mention your name.
My wife is Tony Adeleke. I think people knew her already. Tony Adeleke, my wife.
Wonderful. Sasa, since this pastor of a team, people they invite you to programs, right?
Yes.
When people invite you to programs, if you don't want to go, what did they tell you? Now you go tell yourself, I don't want to go to this place, or not God. And which way?
Well, it's very rare for me to say I don't want to go. Because one of the resolutions I made, and the kind of covenant I have with God is that anywhere I'm invited to come and preach the word of God, I will go there. Shemi, Nami go preach.
Yes.
When I go, if no matter your denomination, they will give me mic.
Exactly.
Now me go talk.
Yes.
Chicken. It's whatever it says to me. That whatever God says to me, Jesus says to me, whatever the Holy Spirit says to me, that I will say out. Yeah. Anywhere they ask me to come. Except I've never had the experience that I have to say I will not go. Mm-hmm. Whether the church is big, whether the church is small, whether they are white garments, men themselves. Okay, I'll go.
I speak with, you get some pastors, they say, then go first consult God. If God say, make them go.
Maybe they don't know the Bible. You don't need to consult God to preach the gospel. Mm-hmm. It's a command. Mm-hmm. Asheni now, go out and preach
the word of God.
To all creatures.
Even make it be say the place when somebody they go, no good. But make somebody go there, go preach.
Now you go
they
can win souls. No, he said, you are the light of the world.
Exactly.
You are the light of
that way.
This thing that is set on the hill. See, let me tell you this, and I have no apology. If they will ask me to come to the garden of Babalawo to come and preach the gospel,
somebody go surrender.
I'll be the happiest person to go. I will go there and go and tell them that this thing you are following is not right.
But how many people know this when they talk so?
Because they don't know it. They don't know it.
Did we really go? Then they really go inside Bible.
Then like that, because this gospel, you know, maybe they didn't have the kind of encounter.
Because I love what you said now. If they call you in the midst of Babalawo, you go preach.
I will go there now.
Out of the 10 Babalawo, 5.
They will give their lives to Christ.
But some people go say, ah, I go first consult God. God, if God say,
you know what? No, see, there are some things that you don't need to consult God about.
Yeah.
Because the Bible is clear. It's just like something that is expressly clear in the Constitution. That a layman can read it, there is no ambiguity. You know, what makes people to carry the case to Supreme Court is because of ambiguity. They will not need judges to go and interpret it. But when a case is very clear, simple case, you don't go to Supreme Court. There's no ambiguity about it. See, until Jesus Christ will come back, me, I will continue to preach the gospel to whoever cares to listen.
I like that.
Anywhere. So I've never had God to say, I will not go. Why won't
they
I go?
They call you, not go.
No.
Because
it's not possible.
They have no pure. It's when you come there.
I will go and tell them that everybody that their hands is not pure. When
surrender. See, I like Bishop Adeleke and David Naina. So Bishop, I like that action.
That is it now.
I get that kind of...
we have gone to places that after ministry, even pastors stood up to give their life to Christ.
Wonderful.
That is it.
Okay,
now.
Is it possible?
It's possible.
To preach somewhere.
Yes.
Pastors, me when I be pastor before,
yes.
I just the fake una.
Yes.
But now I don't surrender.
Oh,
to Jesus,
yeah,
I surrender. Bishop.
And there's no testimony that is sweeter than that. They will never forget. That one man came and changed the whole story. That is it. So the answer said, because the hand of the pastor is not pure, I'm not going there. What I cannot do is I cannot carry somebody that his hand is not clean to my own church. That's one thing I cannot do. If I know a man of God that his hands is not clean, that what he's doing is not in line with the Bible.
But how did you know? How
I will know. You know, there's a spirit they call discernment. The spirit of even this. That I'm going to go preach in any place doesn't mean that I will not know. I will know that where I'm going is not clean. So that will help me. You know, when you are going to a place that you know that the ground is not clean, you don't
you ready.
You don't okay. When I went to South Africa, what they were telling me is that some pastors were telling me what to preach about. That here they don't preach holiness, so they don't preach against things, you know, because even the pastors are committing sin. So something happened. Whenever I take their mic like this, I will not know the time I'll be saying my own.
That's Holy Spirit
led. Yes. By the time I began to say my own, everybody will give their life to Christ.
Ooh.
Even that same message that they said I should not preach, that when I preach, people will not come. People will like it. If it's 3 days program, second day, people will be more. Third, see, there's a dimension of man that want to please God. But pastors are failing in their responsibility of not telling man where they are failing. So if you can point man to God, there is a dimension of man that want to respond to God. That is it. Because you don't want to, in South America they will say, just preach for prosperity, preach healing, preach, so you don't preach holiness. But you see, sometimes there's something that what brought it to their life is because of their sin. So total gospel is what I embrace.
Wonderful.
And what I preach.
I like that. I like that. Because I've been hearing it. Really. I don't want to go to church. I don't want to do this one. I go first ask God. Pastor, this question, when I was in a song, I go take singer. Then you go take I want to ask you one question, but not true song.
Okay.
Then you go come, tell me the thing we go ask God. Then, count your blessings, then they're one by one. Count your blessings, see what Lord has done. Count your blessings, then they're one by one. Now, the thing we God don't do for you.
It's good to count your blessings. But do you know that the most important blessings are not really uncountable? Because they are intangible. Okay, how will you count the life that God has given to you?
Wonderful.
How will you count it? But you see,
African,
what that song is saying is that so that you can reflect, you know, be wise in your thoughts. Only thing about Manuro,
Amopedu.
Be wise in your thoughts, you know. Because no matter how blessed you think that you are, that's something that you are still trusting God for. But men in their foolishness tend to pay attention to what God has not done than what God has done. So, like myself, I know God has blessed me. At my age, God, I'm still strong. I'm not weak.
Yeah.
I'm not nursing anything. Yeah. I've seen many things.
As a part of that training, though.
Yes. I've seen many things. I've been faced by afflictions and tribulations and infirmities and sicknesses, but you see, I've overcome them. I have issues. I've overcome them. So today I can say that I'm a blessed man.
Hallelujah.
And because when we talk of blessing, we talk, people think of money. Mm-hmm. But money is good, it's part of the blessing. But the blessings that are greatest are the ones that money cannot buy, that you cannot really place your hands on them. That you are able to sleep yesterday.
That okay. Like breathing.
And you, yeah, they are breathing. So if it matter gets to breathing now, you know, see a lot of factors coming in. Something that we have never had before. We began to hear it since last year. Because something assimilator or whatever, mm-hmm. Something later, something that when somebody cannot breathe again.
Oxygen?
Apart from oxygen, there's something they normally use for the people that have COVID-19.
Exactly.
That thing is very.
Yes.
So, and some people have millions of naira. They even use that thing for them. It didn't work. So, how can you quantify that kind of blessing? That's why I said, me, I'm a very blessed man. Highly blessed. And I'm thanking God for blessing me.
God, we thank you. Yes. Is there any book at all you wrote? Any book?
I wrote, I can say, books. Two books I've written.
The name?
One is Profiting with Your Passion. Another one is Secret of Plenty. Secret of Plenty. But in this new year that we are entering, there are some books that are already ready, but I've not published them.
Okay.
I'll try publish them.
When is it coming out?
Let's say in this year that we are entering.
This year.
I'll try and... I just kept myself busy.
Okay.
You know, book writing requires you to really settle down. And maybe I can say it's not really my niche. Because I'm not somebody that sit down and in one place. I'm a very active person. So that's what has hampered the publication of those books. But the books are already, they're already in a raw state. So it's just a matter of finishing them up. Then several years ago, I've done some books, but a friend of mine that I gave one little book to publish for me. But that book was not even my own. It was an American friend, a white American friend, that said, okay, go and publish it and sell it in Nigeria. So we want to work together, we want to collaborate together. So the agreement I have with that, it's a friend though, it's a publisher.
Yeah.
The agreement we had was that, okay, if you publish this, this is another one that you are going to publish. Do you know that it messed up the publication?
Wonderful.
3 years, the book was not ready. By the time the book came, he wanted to be selling those books instead of carrying it from... He has his own that he has published in America. You know, Nigeria is good in public printing and publishing.
Yes, exactly.
So, and I know that this my friend could do it, but it's just a typical Nigerian thing. He just messed it up. So 3 years, in fact 4 years, it became a major fight before he did it. So that thing became a major disappointment and discouragement for me. Mm-hmm. So I've had like 6 or 10 books by now.
Well, we're still there for inside studio here, Solab TV. Now, maybe this the corner we do so now. We call it the call. Maybe the call of prophet, the call of pastor, and the call of bishop. My name still remains normal, like Jetun Soibu. For inside studio here, we get Bishop David Adeleke. Bishop, before we go break, come back on the roundup. Bishop, is there any time since we don't accept God? Maybe say something happened, you can't say, oh God, why?
Well, there is no human being, no matter the level you are, that you don't have things, that you will almost be saying, God, why? But wisdom is that you don't ever have to say, God, why? Because, one, the Bible says we should thank God in all things. Of course, if you do business and you run at a loss, you say, God, why? But if you look critically...
But if you do business, come gain.
And you will not say, God, why?
You're not going to say, God, why?
But when you do business, you do say, God, why? You put a lot of effort, and the effort is not yield in the returns. You say, God, why? Or as a pastor, there are experience that pastors have that labor on a member. And experience have proven to us that it's members that labor on top most that will always turn against you or abandon you or turn their back to you. You want to say, God, why? But if you know God, the way of God, there's nothing that God does without a reason. And for anything that happens, God has a purpose for permitting it. Because John said that nobody can get anything except it's been given to him from heaven.
Thank you. Then, before we go that break, the positive, anything we God does, when we say, God, I thank you, I bless your name.
There are a lot of things.
Hallelujah.
There are a lot of things that I thank God for. I thank God for my family. I thank God for the ministry because God didn't make the ministry to be difficult for me. God, even when it's supposed to be difficult,
so easy,
it just work out. And that's the reason why I don't need any other prophets.
How old is the ministry?
Our ministry is 10 years old.
10 years and
now.
I don't...
It's okay.
I see some people go, because they have spent 20 years.
Because when people come around, they don't believe that we are just 10 years. But, and the ministry has taken that shape since we were barely 5, 6 years. They are taking this proper shape. Everything has been in place by the 6th year. We are just consolidating on it. Yes. Okay, like we wanted to buy a diesel generator recently, and it was like a tall order. But God still did it. We just installed it. We are just installing it. So there's nothing that we need that God has not do? That doesn't supply.
So God, we thank
so
you.
God is always faithful.
So let's go up there. Make we go up there. My name is still remain normal. Like just go. And we're there here with Bishop David Adeleke. Don't forget, say the numbers when I take call. They for scream. Call Bishop. Say hello, sir. Even greet him. Merry Christmas. Anywhere. Make we go up there. My producer, will they come back? Welcome back to the program. People they enjoy the program. I even enjoy my bishop. I do enjoy Bishop. Bishop, I feel like saying, man, I don't just leave you for one.
You go leave me. Make I go do the work of God.
Bishop, this is anointing. I get the power to the tap anointing. And this anointing, we go use the anointing for
you. The people are waiting for me. I told you that I will not stay long here.
Bishop,
because people are waiting for me.
Bishop, out of the 100% of anointing, we will use 70 here.
Let us ordain you now as a pastor. We are looking for people to do the work of God. But when we ordain you, send you to Northeast.
Northeast.
And preach to the Boko Haram people there.
I will do it. I think somebody is gumi. I go do them. I go do them. Believe me honestly. I will go. Nah. But Bishop, I find out that some people they say they be pastor, they be this, they ordain themselves. Does it happen in
people don't know, and that reason why it doesn't work. You see, if you check the Bible very well, nobody takes it upon themselves to bear any title. But nowadays, you see some people, they just pick up a title and begin to bear it.
They be reverend.
And that is, yes.
The bishop.
That's why.
Pastor.
Yes. You see, you discover, few people that God ordained directly. People like Moses. People like Moses, God ordained, he had an encounter with God. Directly. Then Moses had to ordain Joshua. And the Bible says when Moses laid his hand upon Joshua, the spirit of wisdom came upon him. Elijah, you know, ordain Elisha. So it's like that. Don't just go and take the title and be behind him.
Sir, but is it,
if you see people that take title and be behind him, you discover that their ministry will be ended.
Sir, you talk about Moses now. Mm. God ordained him.
Yeah, directly. Yes.
So it is possible. Make we see some pastors or
there's very few pastors. God will just call them in a spectacular way. And of course, the Bible says, by their fruit we shall know it. By the result of the work, you will know that God called this person directly. But even then, experience that I have is that even when it seems as if God called you directly like that, you need to undergo some tutelage. Because this is ministry is a very, very big matter, a very, very big assignment. Because the life and destiny of people are entrusted to pastor. So if you don't have the knowledge, try and error will make, you will destroy, you will ruin the destiny of many people. You will ruin the marriages of many people. Mm. You will mislead many people. You still need experience. Even the Moses that we are talking about, he has learned the way of shepherding. You know, shepherding through the in-law. So he knows how the way of a shepherd. So, and the calling of Moses was the calling of a shepherd. So he knows that, it's just a matter of applying it, like we talk of applied mathematics. So applying that one to the calling of leading the people of God. So that's it. So for Joshua was following him, learning the rope, learning the way. So it was even easier for Joshua because Joshua had to learn from the mistakes of Moses. That was the reason why Joshua was able to fulfill the purpose of God for him and for the Israelites. He entered the land, he acquired the land, and shared for the children of Israel.
Thank you. So, like those people who want to become pastor now, which advice do you give?
So anybody who want to become pastor, number one, you don't just wake up and say you want to become pastor.
Say, God, don't call me.
Because pastor work is like medical, like doctors. Okay. So you don't just wake up and say, because maybe you are dreaming and you are giving somebody paracetamol in your sleep, then you have become a doctor. So you just have to serve under somebody. It's very, very important. No matter how anointed, or some people, they have not been pastor, they have not been anything, even maybe they have not even given they are just giving their life to Christ. When they pray for somebody, the prayer will be answered. Come. It doesn't mean that you go and open church and say you have arrived. You must go and serve, learn how to do this work, so that you will not destroy, you will not ruin the destiny of many people.
Wonderful.
So that's my counsel to the young people. Okay. And when you are serving under a ministry, make sure that they release you properly.
They don't release like you. Like somebody who won't go learn work, tailoring job.
They will
you must
freedom.
Allow your God to do freedom and pray freedom for you.
And pray
if
for
he don't
you
don't pray for you, the thing not go work out. You go see some people go say, pastor go there and say, place when you learn work, you don't finish. Go back, make your God pray for you.
So it will make the work of the ministry very easy. And this is so tricky because it's a spiritual thing. You cannot really lay your hands on it. When you are committing it, you will not know. You think that you can just walk away, it's not to open a place, maybe. And there are some people that will be deceiving you. They'll say they will give you money. Ministry, even with money, if God is not in it, it will not work.
Nothing.
I've seen people that have a lot of money. They make so much noise. They have so much money. Some people are bankrolling them. And if people are bankrolling you and the thing is not working, just a matter of time.
They will be tired.
Okay. The people that are bankrolling you will be tired.
Okay.
But if God has called you and you have partners and they are bankrolling you, when they see the result, they will be interested in doing more.
Exactly.
And it won't be only one person. Other people will be supporting the ministry.
Thank
the ministry
you.
Will continue to grow.
Thank you, sir. Sir, lastly, before we go, which advice you get for our Nigerian leaders?
Well, Nigerian leaders, they should fear God. Then they should quit greed. Nigeria has enough for everybody's needs, but it doesn't have enough for everybody's greed. The problem with Nigeria is that the leadership is greedy. Even the followership, everybody is greedy. Greed is foundation of corruption. When people are greedy, they'll be corrupt.
Okay.
There's no sense of commitment. There's no sense of sacrifice. Everybody just wants to take their own. And even in your family, your own, your nuclear family, So if the wife is taking, everybody just taking. Nobody wants to bring.
Nobody wants to drop.
Finish now. You exactly. See not. You won't see anything on the ground. Empty. And that's where Nigeria is. Okay. You know, we should always think of how to make this country better, not what we are going to take out of it. When you have an appointment, what should be in your mind is how am I going to make this country better, not what I'm going to take. So we sometimes we take and we drain Nigeria of the blood of life.
Thank you, sir. Sir, we started with prayer, then yes. Let's run with prayer, then only move with that.
Let us pray. Father in heaven, we just thank you. We appreciate you for this wonderful organization. Father, we pray that you bless them.
Amen.
Let them be successful.
Amen.
I pray for all the ears and eyes that have watched and heard us. Amen. I pray that I shall be well with you.
Amen.
In this end of the year, calamity, disaster will not be your portion.
Amen.
And we shall enter 2022 together.
Amen.
And you are not going to enter that year empty-handed.
Amen.
You shall enter 2022 be fully loaded with blessings.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray for Malaje, God will continue to move your profession forward.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Thank you very much. And you are who? What's your name again?
Bishop David Adeleke.
Bishop, thank you very much. Now, Bishop, I don't hear you. Bishop, don't move again. Bishop, we promise us, if we call you next time, you will come.
I will come now, of course. Right. Enjoy this spirit. Of this place is good, so I will be coming next
so
time.
Good spirit day here, Solab Television 9BD. Make we go upstairs. Then if I come back, I'll come the park. If I come back, make I tell you a little bit about my birthday. I'll come the park, my load. They tell me, I say bye-bye. And they come back. Nef Kevin, let's go upstairs. Will they come back? Well, welcome back to the program, Solar Television. I mean, it's my name now. Thank God, we don't come to the close of the. We don't come closer. This is the last bottom part of the program. Just small thing I go talk. People call. My producer, what is happening with our? If you are seeing a network, hold the lines. The two lines where they here. I don't know what's wrong, but I believe say tomorrow. If it be network, the thing we put down before. Before I go into my birthday, happy birthday to you. Omolaje. Happy birthday to you. Did you want the headline when I put for here that time? Did you want to talk about topic for here that time? They say hike in price of transportation. Again, probably not talk small thing about it. Now, Nigeria here, the thing they happen. Nigeria here, especially Lagos. Now, Lagos, we did. Though, at the travel from Lagos, go other states too. Other states too, it be like that. I believe, say, I don't ask somebody before, say, for advanced country, during the festive period, how they be? They say government, they help people. They say sometimes, the people motor, you may not pay, and this and that. We've been the same for Lagos here before. Or maybe some state, maybe say, I want to put motor down, no. For those who want travel. But I don't know why, this time around, not dig, and everything just they high. Not be say full cost to, not be say this will change or whatever. Everything they high. Make we stop that in inconveniencing people, because of one do Christmas, one do everything go come just day high. You understand? Even food, we started from food last week. As food go come day high, this one go day high. Food we don't get for inside house before. Those when they sell something, the thing we don't get for your shop before, you go just high. The thing bring the price high. People not go feed buy them. See, it's not good, it's unfair. May God help us. Make Natu try to help somebody. You be a transporter. If you put motor down, say people we won't go home. We won't travel go east. We won't travel go north. And we won't travel go south. Just put motor down. People go enter and then go bless you. Then go pray. And that prayer go catch you. That prayer go do you. That one and that. For Nigeria, but we know as it take happen. Anytime when festival don't come, the time when some people take make money, and at the same time, small hold up will catch them. Since money, hold up catch us, then go add the whole money when they won't make for that day. Then go add up for passenger head. So then that make we change. Let's change. If you want call, the number there for the screen, when you go take call. Make a quickly tell today na my birthday, December 27. That year, December 27, I thank everybody who be part of my birthday today. You realize that as from 5 a.m., people don't they call me from the radio. They're almost like, I don't want to speak, we want to talk to you. Now, God will not be me. Money not day, but it's a big person. No person, money never too much, but I not be so hungry they catch me, but you understand. I thank God Almighty. You about to say in your last show, since money, those when they call me, when they wish me happy birthday, those when they hook for radio, virtually the whole radio waiting for Lagos. You understand now? I thank God. Omolaje was born late 60s. Forget about statue. Forget the statue. The only thing I be defined before. I want out of make my belly big, you understand, big belly. So that people go even know say I get the age. But the belly no come. Not be by force. Even make I drink blood tonic, I not go fat. So why drinking blood tonic? Or why drinking mau mau? You understand? So I thank God I was born into the family of RSM, Regional Sergeant Major Afolabi Anes. So my mother is from Iseluku, Delta State. And my dad is from Ondo State, Ibokoda local government area. I'm from But now Lagos here we did. You know, say for Lagos here, everybody get in place where they. So I have to say we did for Majidu. Majidu, precise. I thank God for adding another year to my year. So I did start another fresh. I start another fresh year again. I thank God Almighty. Those who make it possible. I wish myself happy birthday. You understand? Thank you. God, I thank you. See, people, they still remember me. I know sick, I know doing it. I thank God. I thank my family. I thank everybody. Now, so with the siam for today, with the pack our load, small. I did always salute to our Bunge producer. Producer, when they do 1, 2, 3 job at the same time. Now you go set like producer, you too much. Nef Kevin Machuku, aka Apostle, you too much. Wale Olawale, Olawale still there much around. Olawale they much around for tomorrow until tomorrow again. In case you won't call me after the program here, or even you won't say something, they say Pikin won't go chop yam, go take bread, send message, go village. Before the village won't go send yam come. If you won't call me or congratulate us, Omolaje, I don't say you. Somebody say, wait me my name, and Omolaje, I don't say you, don't take over the name for the industry. For the past 22 years in broadcasting industry, my name is Anthony Adewale Anes. Anthony Adewale Anes. But Omolaje, anywhere Omolaje, I don't say you. So put that one for the back of your mind, for the back of your hand. But my fans that they call me Omolaje Tosoibo. I thank everybody. You won't call me, maybe WhatsApp, you won't WhatsApp me, or you won't tell me anything, or you won't do advert on this television. The number now 080-36-819-254. 080-36-819-254. Make a quick salute our chairman. Chairman of Solab Television. You see they say Bosa. We see your hand, okay? In case you know here, when we start program, I see they salute you. I said the person will chop, when we make another man chop, we throw a salute to you. We see your hand, though, the chairman of Solab Television, we throw a salute to you. You say three Bosa. Until tomorrow again, when we go come here, that same time to give you the program. What you do? What you go like? My name still remain Omolaje Tosoibo. Bye-bye.